Wait, however.
Good morning, good morning. Good morning to all.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning, good morning. What was the last thing we covered in the previous class?
The rolling as a combination of pure translational and rotational, and then we did one question like a hollow sphere with water, non-viscous wall, liquid in it.
Okay. We introduced rolling. Did we introduce hinges?
No.
No, sir.
No, sir. No, sir.
We did not, sir.
Just wanted to ask that, have you discussed the assignment of conservation of momentum which you had sent last week?
Yes.
I don't know. Your classmates should say. Somebody said yes, and probably I might have discussed.
Okay, sir.
Sir, we haven't received the recording of the last doubt lecture which was held.
Sir doesn't have access to it.
I don't have access to it yet. There was a change in the Zoom. Renewal policy of Zoom. That day they were going through the transition. Exactly 1 year back they took this policy, they had to renew it. So in the transition of renewal, that day we couldn't get any of the video lectures.
So in that only you had discussed the assignment doubts. So like if we have doubts now, then because like everyone had not solved that assignment. So if they have doubts now again, then we don't even have the recording.
Then tomorrow you have a doubt lecture, right?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
That will avail it.
Okay, sir. Okay.
Ab suno. We will build on rolling. Dhyan se suniye. And the class will be important. Right? Pay attention, concentrate. Now, you said when a body is rolling, point of contact is at rest with respect to the surface. This is the necessary condition for rolling. This point is everybody clear about?
Yes, sir.
Now, for me to deal with any dynamic equation, first of all, I should know how to take the forces on it.
Yes, sir.
One among the most complicated force for me is friction. So first, let us understand how friction acts on these bodies. When the body is rolling or if the body is slipping. Direction of friction, direction, value of friction. Next class, you people remind me that I will first have to deal with hinges, hinge force, right? Or probably I will start off in the last part of today's class. If I don't start hinges next class, remind me about that. Is that clear?
Yes, make sir. A note
yes,
in your
sir.
Notes.
Yes, sir.
Now, direction of friction. Please observe this. This is BCM. This is omega. What is the velocity of the point of contact with respect to ground? Velocity of point of contact with respect to center of mass plus velocity of center of mass with respect to ground. Velocity of point of contact with respect to center of mass plus velocity of center of mass with respect to ground. Now, what is velocity of point of contact with respect to center of mass? It will be R omega with respect to center of mass.
Yes, sir.
It will be R omega with respect to center of mass. Right? Minus R omega plus VCA. This is positive. This is negative. So, velocity of point of contact with respect to ground. Case 1, if VCM is equal to R omega, that implies velocity of point of contact with respect to ground is 0. That means the body is rolling. This is what you explained to me in the previous class. So far, so good. Yes or no?
Yes,
yes,
sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Now the problem is, friction is less than mu n. Kyun bhai sir? Friction, why should it be less than mu n? Point of contact is at rest. So friction will be less than or equal to mu n, maybe even equal. Point of contact is at rest. When point of contact is at rest, the point is not slipping. Rolling is, body is not slipping. when it is not slipping, rolling is no slipping condition. No slipping condition. When the body is not slipping, point of contact is at rest, friction will be lesser than mu. Friction will be lesser than mu. Second, how do you decide the direction of friction? Take either forward or backward. Solve the problem. If friction turns out to be positive, direction taken is correct. If friction turns out to be negative, direction taken is wrong. If friction turns out to be negative, direction taken is wrong. Why are you saying this? Why don't you give us the direct condition, whether it is forward or backward? It depends on the problem. Have a look at it. I am at rest. Somebody from behind is pushing me. I am trying to restrain and I go this way. I am holding my feet on the ground. I am holding my feet on the ground. When somebody from behind is pushing me, friction on me is in the backward direction?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Point of contact is at rest. Now that person came to the front and is pushing me in the backward direction. I am trying to hold on to my position. Now friction on my feet is in forward direction.
Forward direction.
We are at rest with respect to ground. Before and after. My feet are at rest with respect to ground. So depending on the direction of the force and the situation of the problem, direction of friction will change. Hence, you have to go with the problem. Assume a direction of friction, either forward or back. Solve the problem. You get positive, direction taken is correct. But one important point. When the body is rolling, do not ever conclude that friction is mu n. Friction could be less than or equal to mu n because body is toppling about the point. Point of contact is at rest with respect to the surface. If the point is at rest, there is no slipping. No slipping means friction will be less than or equal to mu n. So take F as friction. Solve the problem. F is positive. Direction you have taken is correct. F is negative. Direction you have taken is wrong. This is case one. Take it down till here.
Sir.
Hello.
Sir, I had a doubt in the condition of rolling. Sir, in the last lecture, we took that we took the case where the velocity of center of mass is r omega, right? But sir, can't we consider the case where it's initially at rest, so we have to apply an external force for it to start rolling? Sir, so won't it start accelerating in that case?
Force maine lagaya kisi par.
Sir, to body roll kaise karega?
That's a different issue. Did I apply any force on any of the body?
No, sir.
No, when I apply a force, we will deal with that surface.
Okay, sir.
Everything cannot be introduced in one go. We'll go step by step.
Okay, sorry. Thank you, sir.
Sir, if there is no friction, that means that the point will slip, no?
Even that condition we'll come to in today's class. Wait for.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Hello, sir.
Hi.
So how will we take the dynamic equations in these cases? Can you please give an example?
So ye topic chhod do abhi.
No, sir. Sorry, sir.
Wo dynamic equation tak aayenge. Have patience.
done.
Now, case two, what if VCM is greater than RM? What if VCM is greater than RM? That means velocity of point of contact with respect to the ground is positive. Velocity of point of contact with respect to the ground is positive. That means point of contact is slipping in the forward direction. Slipping in forward direction. If the point of contact is slipping, what will be the value of friction?
Mu n.
Mu n.
The limiting value. And friction is in backward direction. Why backward? Point is slipping in forward direction. Friction is loyal to the surface on which it acts. If the point is slipping in the backward direction, friction will make sure that there's no slipping at the point of contact. Because of which the center of mass may move, it is not bothered about it. Its prima facie concern is the relative slipping between two points should stop. So here friction's value is mu n and it will be in the backward direction. What will case 3 be? VCM is lesser than RM. VCM is lesser than RM. Right? So, velocity of point of contact is negative. That means POC is slipping in. Point of contact is slipping in backward direction. What will be the value of friction? Mu n. What will be the direction? Forward.
Forward.
So far, so good.
Sir, do you mind repeating the case 2 again? Actually, your screen froze in between. That's why I couldn't hear.
VCM is greater than RM. This is greater than this. So point of contact, velocity will be positive. That means point of contact is slipping in the forward direction. So point is slipping, value of friction will be mu n and it will be in backward direction.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir. So friction is always going to be the reverse of POC, right? As in direction.
Friction opposes relative motion between the point of contact and the surface. Friction opposes the relative motion between the point of contact and the surface.
Okay, sir.
So when you're saying that the point of contact is slipping, is it moving or is it accelerating? I'm not able to understand that.
Slipping. The point is moving with respect to the surface.
So it's moving with a constant velocity or?
Could be anything. Could be moving with constant velocity, could be accelerating.
So it is not at rest with respect to the ground.
obviously not at rest. Likha hua hai na yaar, point
yes,
is
sir. Yes, sir.
Rest we have dealt with for rolling.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Thank you.
Okay. So a vehicle will move forward in the third case, right?
Nein. Vehicle moves forward while rolling also, while slipping, either of these two conditions also. Don't run, you will not understand. Jo padhaya ja raha hai, us par concentrate kar. Vehicle ka moment will come in the fourth lecture from now. Abhi kahan chod ke bhag jaunga yaar.
Sorry, sir. Noted,
sir. Done, sir.
आप लोगों को फोर्स अप्लाई करने की जल्दी है. डोंट, वी विल कम टू इवन दैट फोर्स अप्लाई. We are going in a systematic way. Don't dislodge the tire. Now, what if on an incline, body rolling on an incline. Now, is it rolling up or rolling down? First of all, I will take this rolling down. First point, as it is, if you people observe, till now VCM is equal to R omega is the condition for rolling. Right? VCM yes. equal to R omega is the condition for rolling. Differentiation of VCM with respect to time, d omega by dt is ACM is equal to R alpha. ACM is equal to R alpha. Now observe this. If this is ACM, or first I show you the forces, I will have mg sin theta this way, mg cos theta this way, and normal force like. First point, on a smooth inclined plane, torque is zero. Why is the torque zero? Mg is passing through the center of mass, normal force is passing through the center of mass. On a smooth inclined plane, there is no torque. That means alpha is zero. Implies ACM equal to R alpha cannot be satisfied. Why can it not be satisfied? I know center of mass has an acceleration of g sin theta. Alpha is zero. Now this is not equal to this. Hence body cannot roll. Body cannot roll on a smooth inclined plane. There must be friction on an inclined plane for it to roll. But I didn't say this about a horizontal surface. Horizontal surface I will come to after that. Right now on an inclined plane I'm analyzing. Do I have friction here? No. It's a smooth incline. All forces are passing through the center of mass. Torque about the center of mass is zero. So alpha is zero. ACM equal to R alpha cannot be satisfied. Hence the body doesn't roll on a smooth inclined plane. Is this point clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Now, what if I take a rough inclined plane? I'll analyze, take it down till here.
Sir, sir, alpha comes out to be zero, but omega can be non-zero, right?
वो एनालिसिस भी हो जाएगा. ओमेगा आल्सो इट विल बी कांस्टेंट, मे बी नॉन जीरो बट इट विल बी कांस्टेंट. दैट वोंट हेल्प यू. बी इज इंक्रीजिंग.
ओके,
बिकॉज़ देयर इज नो टॉर्क, ओमेगा विल बी कांस्टेंट.
सो बट यू हैव
टू डू द एनालिसिस इन 2 मिनट्स. हैव पेशेंस, इन 2 मिनट्स आई विल बी कमिंग टू दैट एनालिसिस.
ओके सर, कैन यू अगेन गिव द रीजन व्हाई टॉर्क विल बी जीरो?
ऑल फोर्सेस आर पासिंग थ्रू द सेंटर ऑफ मास.
Okay sir, got it.
Only friction is the force which doesn't pass through center of mass. Can I rub the boat?
Yes, sir. 1 minute.
Yes, sir. Answer.
Carefully listen to what is being told. Don't even blink. Don't get diverted. If there's a disturbance in your room, please use earphones and listen carefully. Body rolling down on an incline. I'll change the submitting. Down. Body rolling down. This analysis you should know. You are first learning how to draw the friction on the rolling body. Then I'll go to the dynamic equations, forces, accelerations. First learn how to use friction on a dynamic, on a rolling body. Then dynamic equations. Then accelerations. Right? Now, body is rolling down. So that means ACM is in the downward direction. Body rolling down on rough incline. On rough incline. So have a look at it. How do I decide the direction of friction? Is it upwards or is it downwards? That's the question. Once I know direction of friction, I can write the dynamic equation and the torque equation. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So now, whole of the job is right now concentrated on knowing only direction of friction. First of all, ACM is down the incline. I'm sure about it. Anybody with a doubt here?
No, sir.
No, sir.
Acceleration of point of contact is ACM minus R alpha. Should be zero, or I'll write that step also. acceleration of point of contact with respect to ground is acceleration of point of contact with respect to O plus acceleration of O with respect to ground. Now this is ACM. This is ACM. This is down the incline. So this should be up the incline because this should be zero. Up the incline. This is down the incline. So this must be up the incline. Is this point okay with all?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So you mean to say R alpha, acceleration of point of contact with respect to O is R alpha. R alpha is up the incline. Do you all agree with that?
Yes, sir.
R alpha will be up the incline if and only if alpha is in anti-clockwise direction. R alpha
yes, sir.
Up the incline if and only if alpha must be in anti-clockwise direction. Alpha is produced by what? Torque. Torque must be in anti-clockwise direction. Only friction produces torque in this case. Friction is the only force producing torque. Mg and normal force are passing through the center of mass. Now, torque must be in anti-clockwise. And only friction is producing torque. So compulsorily friction should be up the incline because I want anti-clockwise torque. Friction is downwards, it will become clockwise torque. Friction is upwards, it will be anti-clockwise torque. Friction is up the incline.
Yes.
So that APOC with respect to ground is zero just because the point of contact is stationary with respect to
rolling,
the surface.
Rolling.
Okay, sir. But
this is zero implies this is down the incline. This must be up the incline. So R alpha is up the incline. Alpha must be in anti-clockwise direction. Torque must be in anti-clockwise direction. Only friction is producing torque. So the friction must be up the incline. Thamba. Body rolling up. Body rolling up the rough incline. What will be the direction of friction? Concept is the same. Can you make a guess what will be the direction of friction?
Downwards.
Listen.
Upwards.
It's rolling up. Matlab, it is decelerating upwards. Decelerating. D-E-C-E-L-E-R-A-T-I-N-G. That means it is accelerating downwards. I throw a body in the upward direction. It is decelerating upwards, accelerating
downwards.
Nothing will change. Friction is again in the upward direction. Understand the difference between sliding and rolling. Body is rolling. So it is decelerating upwards. So ACM is downwards. ACM is downwards. R alpha is upwards, right? ACM is downwards. Since ACM minus R alpha should be zero. So ACM is downwards. R alpha is upwards. Alpha must be in anti-clockwise direction. Torque must be in anti-clockwise direction. Friction is the only force providing dot implies friction is up the incline. Whether the body is rolling down or rolling up, friction will be
up the incline.
Now some of you will get a genuine doubt. चीटिंग कर रहे हो सर. अभी तक VCM इक्वल टू R ओमेगा बोल बोल के हमें ये बताया गया है कि पॉइंट ऑफ कॉन्टैक्ट शुड बी एट रेस्ट विथ रेस्पेक्ट टू द सरफेस. अब ये एनालिसिस करने के लिए क्वाइटली यू शिफ्टेड अस फ्रॉम VCM टू ACM. व्हाई? बिकॉज़ वेदर द बॉडी इज गोइंग डाउन और अप, एक्सेलरेटिंग इज डाउनवर्ड्स. सो फॉर यू जॉब बिकेम इजी. मगर VCM इक्वल टू R ओमेगा लेकर एनालाइज करोगे तो एक केस में VCM डाउनवर्ड से, इस केस में VCM अपवर्ड से. यू कैन नॉट टेल मी VCM इज डाउनवर्ड, बॉडी इज रोलिंग अप.
यस सर.
कैन यू डू एनालिसिस पर फ्रिक्शन यूजिंग VCM एंड शो दैट यू विल गेट द सेम रिजल्ट? ऑब्वियसली यस, प्रोवाइडेड यू गिव मी द बोर्ड.
सर 2 मिनट्स.
Sir, I'm sorry, sir. Sir, can you repeat the last part once again? I got disconnected.
No, sir. I'll send you the record. Aisa mat kiya.
Okay, sir.
It is the same thing. I have written it. Same thing from the first.
Sir.
Whether body is accelerating, the accelerating downwards or decelerating upwards, it is accelerating downwards. Same point I have written it.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Okay, sir. No problem.
Sir, I have a general doubt. Could you please explain why alpha must be in anti-clockwise direction?
I'm slowly getting accustomed to your voice. You are either a spammer or you are playing with me regularly. This is a pain for me also. Itna achha concept, itna dhang se jab padha gaya. You think you can sit and drag me this way every lecture?
Sir, actually, आज मेरा Wi-Fi down है, इसलिए आवाज कम आ रही है.
Lecture भी recording भेजूंगा. तेरे लिए I will keep 250 students waiting here and I'll keep repeating things. थोड़ा समझ लो भाई साहब, आप class में हो.
Sir, the catch was that when the body is rolling up, velocity is up and friction should oppose relative motion and act downwards. That was the catch, right?
You want me to rub it and explain it? If not, wait.
Yes, sir, after wait, everyone is done copying.
No, they are not. Relax. Amba.
Sir,
Sir,
I had a basic doubt. Even in this, we'll use the normal condition for rolling, right? That F will be lesser than equal to mu n?
Obviously.
Okay, thank you, sir.
Necessary condition for rolling is point of contact is at rest with respect to the surface.
Yes, sir.
Sufficient condition will be friction will be lesser than mu n. Because the point is at rest with respect to the surface.
Yes, sir. Understood. Thank you, sir.
done, sir.
Wait, sir.
Excuse me, sir.
Your voice is not audible.
Sir, not audible.
हल्का सा सुनाई दे रहा है.
Sir, now.
हाँ.
Sir, I am asking that why I'm not considering acceleration in upward direction. There might be some acceleration.
I throw a body in the upward direction. Acceleration is in which direction?
Okay, important.
मैंने ऊपर फेंका. Acceleration कौन सा direction में है?
Sir, जी.
Downwards. Body is rolling up. Acceleration is downwards. G sin theta downwards.
Yes, sir.
You want me to show you that friction either way will be acting up. I should analyze this taking velocity. Is that the point?
Yes, sir.
This is VCM. Now, velocity of point of contact should be zero. That means VCM plus R omega should be minus R omega. Velocity of point of contact should be zero. Velocity of the point of contact with respect to center of mass. Right? So, R omega is up the incline. Do you all agree with this?
Yes, sir.
R omega is up the incline. That means omega is in anti-clockwise direction. Only if omega is in anti-clockwise direction, R omega will be upwards. Now you want this relation VCM equal to R omega to sustain. This should be true all throughout. Till when this is true, point of contact is at rest. Body is rolling down. So if VCM equal to R omega, as the body is rolling down, VCM is increasing. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Omega must be increasing. Omega must be increasing means alpha must be in the direction of omega. That means alpha is in anti-clockwise direction. Alpha is in anti-clockwise direction. Torque must be in anti-clockwise direction. Only friction produces torque in this case. Implies friction is up the incline. I repeat this logic, pay attention. VCM is downwards, for this point it should be at rest, R omega should be up. Only then some of these both can be zero. So omega is in anti-clockwise direction. Now VCM equal to R omega should sustain all throughout the motion, body is rolling. That means as VCM is increasing, omega must also increase, it just cannot increase. Omega must increase means alpha must be in the direction of omega. So alpha must be in anti-clockwise direction. Alpha is in anti-clockwise direction. Torque must be in anti-clockwise direction. Friction is the only force producing torque. So friction must be up the incline when the body is rolling down. This point, is it clear to all?
Yes, sir.
Thank you, sir. Got it.
Now, listen, body rolling up the incline means the tricky part is now velocity is upwards.
velocity is upwards. VCM is in the upward direction. Velocity of point of contact is VCM minus R omega will be zero. Right? So R omega is in which direction? R omega is
downward.
Do you all agree with this?
Yes, sir.
That means omega is in clockwise direction. And for you, VCM equal to R omega must sustain all throughout the relation. As the body is going up, VCM is decreasing. That implies omega must decrease. Only then this relation will sustain. VCM is decreasing. Matlab omega also should decrease. Omega decreases implies alpha must be opposite to direction of omega. Omega is in clockwise. Alpha must be in anti-clockwise direction. Alpha is in anti-clockwise direction. Torque must be in anti-clockwise direction. There is only one force producing torque. Friction is up the incline. Is the complete analysis clear?
Yes, sir.
Now I will write the dynamic equations and solve for the acceleration. First, I should know the direction of friction. Right? Take it down till here. Keep a proper track of your notes. Your notes is your only reference for this concept. No other book will give you this complete analysis.
So, actually, I didn't understand what the difference between, I understood what you did, but I didn't understand the difference between this case and the one before. You've basically done the same thing. When you wrote VCM is increasing, you just wrote found out the direction of acceleration and then the rest is the same as the first case.
Right.
So why did we do the
because
same thing?
People, what is more fundamental? Velocity of point of contact is at rest. They want to see the analysis from the velocity perspective. Acceleration was easy because either way it's accelerating downwards. But when we introduced with velocity, concept of rolling. So using velocity, one it is downwards, one upwards, can we come to the same conclusion? What's the point?
Got it.
Sir, but when we took that acceleration case, we just told that it's not accelerating, but we didn't prove that velocity is also zero, right?
I didn't get you.
Like in the acceleration case, when we were doing accelerations, we just proved that acceleration is zero, but we didn't prove that
acceleration of point of contact.
Yes, sir. But we didn't prove that its velocity is also zero with respect to ground, right?
Right. And velocity being zero is more fundamental in nature for rolling.
Yes, sir.
Hence this analysis.
Okay, sir.
Sir, I'm sorry, but I didn't understand that in one case we took alpha must be in the direction of omega, and in one it should be opposite.
Yeah.
But
here, why omega must be increasing. When will omega increase only if alpha is in the same direction? There omega must be decreasing.
Okay, so when omega is supposed to be decreasing, that time you will take alpha in the opposite direction.
Naturally, you know, your velocity and acceleration only if they're in the opposite direction. Velocity will decrease.
Okay, so got it. Thank you.
Sir?
Can
you make a conclusion that friction will always be up the incline?
For a rolling body on an inclined plane.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Noted.
Great, sir.
Noted.
Now listen. All the three expressions that I derive, you will have to remember. We will use it in so many different chapters as and when we require. Body rolling down an incline, acceleration of a body rolling down an incline. Now this will be mg sine theta, this will be friction. Do you all agree with this?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Mg sine theta minus friction is mass into acceleration. Translational dynamic equation.
Yes, sir.
Acceleration will be the acceleration of?
Center of mass.
Now, torque about COM will be F into R, which will be equal to I into R. Torque about center of mass, F into R equal to I into R. Third equation, alpha is this big. ACM is down the incline, alpha is this way. This will be R alpha. acceleration of this point with respect to center of mass minus r alpha plus acceleration of center of mass with respect to ground should be zero. ACM is equal to r alpha is my third equation. Now here, moment of inertia changes from body to body. One general formula you apply as mk square. K will be called radius of gyration. It is a general formula for all the moment of inertia. What is k? How to calculate? I'll explain in 1 minute from now. Temporarily write that as mk square. You will get mg sine theta minus F will be I'll write here F is equal to mk square by r into alpha. Alpha is a by r. What did I do? I got r to the denominator. I substituted moment of inertia as a general formula mk square. K will be called radius of gyration. I'll explain that in 1 minute. Mk square by r, alpha is a by r. So what do I get friction as? Minus mk square by r square into a is m into a. Friction I substituted from here. M goes g sine theta upon 1 plus k square by r square is the acceleration of the center of mass of a rolling body. Now, you have done something new for moment of inertia. You substituted I as mk square. I will be mk square where k will be called radius of gyration. Radius of gyration. It's a general name given that. Radius of gyration. How do I get this value of radius of gyration? Suppose I am dealing for a ring mr square. I equate it to mk square. What do I get k square by r square for a ring?
K equal to r.
K square by r square is 1. Suppose I deal for a disk. Mr square by 2 is equal to mk square. K square by r square is equal to 1 by 2. Hollow sphere 2 by 3 is equal to mk square. K square by r square is 2 by 3. One more you will write solid sphere. Mk square is equal to 2 by 5 mr square. So I get k square by r square in all the cases. So k is a general expression for moment of inertia. What will k be called as? Radius of gyration. Jo bhi moment of inertia hai, equate it to mk square, you get the value of k. This is the only derivation in the history of IIT entrance examination which was asked as a derivation till date. 2004 JE for 4 marks, they asked this. Derive an expression for acceleration of a body rolling down an inclined plane. It is a standard derivation right from your HSC syllabus till IIT. You cannot afford to forget this formula. And how did you solve this? Translational dynamic equation, rotational dynamic equation, and constraints. Right? Take it down till here. We'll derive an expression for friction and mu as well. G sine theta upon 1 plus k square by r square.
Sir, I had one small doubt.
Hmm.
Sir, what does the significance does k have instead, like, except this, like, I is equal to mk square is a general formula, except that it has any other significance?
No, nothing else. Just to give a general value.
Okay, sir.
Noted, sir.
Noted, sir.
Sir, excuse me, sir. So what is the meaning of gyrations and that and didn't get?
Wo naam hai yaar, bas yaad kar.
Acha, okay.
It is called radius of gyration.
Okay, okay.
A body rolled down by a distance of s on an inclined plane. A body rolls down by a distance of s on an inclined plane. What will be the velocity at the lowermost point? What formula will you use?
So v square equal to u square plus 2as. U is 0.
Initial velocity is 0. Acceleration is
kv calculator
upon 1 plus k square by r
by
r into s. 2g s sine theta, can I call it as h?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Sounds good.
Yes, sir.
Something more important. All of you pay attention. When a body is rolling, condition was point of contact is at
rest.
So friction will not do any work.
Yes, sir.
Point of contact is at rest. Ab work done jab padha rahe the, emphasize kar rahe the, point of at which force is applied, uska displacement lenge. Point of contact is at
rest.
So work done by friction is
zero.
कैसा confirm करूँ यार?
Work energy theorem.
You should get the same answer. loss in potential energy should be gain in loss in potential energy is mgh. ये एक्सप्रेशन तभी लिख सकते हो व्हेन यू नो दैट वर्क डन बाय फ्रिक्शन इज जीरो. लॉस इन पोटेंशियल एनर्जी इज हाफ एम बी सी एम स्क्वायर हाफ आई सी एम ओमेगा स्क्वायर. इज दिस द काइनेटिक एनर्जी?
यस
यस सर यस सर.
राइट, loss in potential energy is rolling body, kinetic energy of the body about its center of mass plus kinetic energy of center of mass with respect to ground. R m v c m square. I, you told me you will write as m k square, radius of variation.
Yes sir.
Yes.
And omega, yes, will be v square by r square. Where from did you get that? VCM is equal to R omega. VCM equal to R omega. Why is VCM equal to R omega? Rolling. Right? M will go. 2G H is VCM square into 1 plus K square by R square. VCM is root over of 2G H upon 1 plus K square by R square. Is this the answer that you are expecting?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Conservation of energy. How could you do mechanical energy conservation? Work done by friction is?
Zero.
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 Why? Because the point of contact is at?
Rest, yes, with respect to.
But the point of contact is changing at every instant, right?
So at that instant? Every instant work done is zero. Add all the zeros.
Okay, sir. Fine.
Can I get the board?
Yes, just a second. still you can rub.
One more small thing is left over. When you started this analysis on an inclined plane, you told me it needs to be rough for a body to roll. Bola ki nahi aapne?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Tell me how rough. Give me the minimum mu value. Tell me how much coefficient of friction you need for the body to roll. Minimum itna hona hai yaar. Tabhi body roll ho. So I will be safe. It needs to be rough. How rough? What is the minimum value of mu for a body to roll down an inclined plane? Mu minimum for a body to roll down the incline. How will you calculate mu minimum? Inequality to chahiye? We started today's class with that analysis. You told me friction should be less than or equal to mu n.
Yes, sir.
Right? Now, turn back your page and in the expression that we have derived, tell me the expression for friction. Here I wrote something for friction. Do you recollect?
I alpha by r. I alpha by r.
Mk square into a.
Mk square alpha a by r square.
Yes, sir.
Right?
Yes, sir.
Now, what is the value of A G sine theta upon 1 plus K square by R? Less than or equal to mu n g cos theta. Friction was M K square by R square into A. I had I alpha. Alpha I substitute as A by R. A I know is g sine theta upon 1 plus k square by r square. You derived it. Mu should be greater than or equal to tan theta upon 1 plus. This k square by r square from the numerator, I bring it to the denominator of the denominator. R square by k square. Minimum value of mu on an inclined plane for the body to roll. Minimum value of mu for the body to roll. Three expressions on an incline. First, we did analysis of direction of friction. It's always up the incline. Then we wrote translational dynamic, rotational dynamic, and constraint relations. Simplified for acceleration, we derive this expression. So, one expression that it is mandatory for you people to remember, acceleration of a body rolling down an inclined plane, g sine theta upon 1 plus k squared by r squared. Second, velocity expression, root over of 2gh upon 1 plus k squared by r squared. Third, minimum mu required for a body to roll down an inclined plane. All three expressions you should remember. Now, understand one thing. See how systematically the analysis keeps going ahead. Unless we follow this systematic approach, learning rotational dynamics will not be easy. I cannot break through. I break, jump, teach you something very interesting here, teach you something very interesting here, teach you something interesting in angular momentum, jump over. You will be jack of all, master of none. We have to follow this systematic order for you to rise to a level where you can solve problems on your own. Now, one student in between, he is typing, do we have cycloid and rotational dynamics? Now, does it make sense to you when I'm teaching something, you want me to leave this and jump over to cycloid and rotation? What do you want me to answer? Yes or no, stop it and go to cycloid, or what are you expecting? Jo padha raha hu wo seekho na yaar. Do we have angular momentum? Okay, chhod dunga kya beech mein angular momentum bhi padhayenge, right? Cycloidal path bhi aayega. Iska kya karun? Chhod dun? What is being taught, please concentrate on it. Learn in a systematic way. You don't want to learn, your fate. Don't disturb me. Cycloid, angular momentum, satellite. Pahle ye to seekh lo.
Sir, noted.
No. Can you make a guess what will the content of the next lecture be?
Hinges
is a separate subtopic which will come in between. I have to cover that. Other than that, continuation of this.
So, diameter
maximum.
On a horizontal surface, I started by analyzing direction of friction on a horizontal surface. But then I moved on to inclined plane.
You will apply forces.
Right. Now, some students had a doubt in between acceleration. On horizontal surface, we'll apply forces. Now, the beauty is, I can apply force here, I can apply force here, I can apply force here. Different parts I apply, alpha will be different. What height should I apply? The complete analysis will take one complete lecture. Right? So we will follow a proper meticulously calculated sequence. Bank on the class. Do not miss the lecture. Keep a proper track of your notes. You miss on the notes, you are in soup. You do not have any proper source to go through the revision. Your class notes will be a complete analysis. Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
Body rotating with VCM not equal to omega. You will understand that when I apply forces at different places, body will not roll in some circumstances. So that analysis will come when I apply force. Right? On a horizontal surface, we will apply force and you will have an understanding. I want all of you to read chapter 9 from Halliday-Resnick-Crane. Chapter 9. From Halliday-Resnick-Crane. All of you, please read chapter 9 from HR.
Yes, sir. Now it's proper.
So, full chapter?
Yeah, complete chapter of chapter 9 of Halliday-Resnick-Crane. Please read chapter 9. Fine. Read the complete theory, then your understanding of the class will become easy.
So,
but wait for one or two more lectures before I can give homework. With what I taught now is only peanuts. I cannot give you sufficient. Directly is formula par dena padega, which don't make sense. Somebody was asking something.
So we had learned like last class that rolling is also pure translational plus pure rotational. Can we apply that here? Like I can't see how it will work here.
Kinetic energy jab liya aapne, kinetic energy half mvcm square plus half icm omega square.
Yes, sir.
Pure translation plus pure rotation hi to hai.
Ha, itna hi hai. Like otherwise, like the first analysis we can't do anything.
No.
Okay.
You have to take only rolling. Now, when it is not rolling, direction of friction on a horizontal surface, we just introduced. We'll build on it in the next class.
Okay.
Wait for two more lectures for homework to creep in. Right now, I'll not be able to give you homework on this. three, four objectives of HCV can be done, but that's okay. It doesn't make much sense. All three expressions, acceleration down an inclined plane, velocity, right, and minimum mu required for a body to roll.
Sir, is rotational dynamics one of the highly weighted chapter in mechanics?
Toughest in mechanics. See you people in tomorrow's doubt lecture. Tomorrow's doubt lecture will be exclusively for doubts. Whatever you people say, some want assignment, booklet ka jo bhi hai. If the doubts are not many, maybe we will stop early. But tomorrow only doubts. It will not be regular class.
Sir, we didn't get the last doubt lecture recording.
Bye, sir.
But some people didn't attend and that lecture recording is not available. So we'll have to repeat it. What can be done?
Sir, I have doubt in velocity wala part. In that part, you have taken s is equal to h in velocity when we calculate velocity.
S is sine theta.
Sine
theta is h. Dhang se dekha nahi aapne. This is s, this is theta, this is h. S sin theta is h. Dekh lo dhang se. You didn't write down your notes properly.
Okay, sir.
See you people in the next class. Good
bye,
day.
Sir. Thank you.
Bye.
Good day.
Thank you.
Bye, sir. Thank you, sir.
Bye, sir.